Hello friends, welcome back. I am Dr. Keshav Mahale and in this lecture we are going to study one more new reactant. Now see the Smith reaction. This is also known as the Smith reaction or Smith rearrangement. So in this reaction, simply carboxylic acid when react with hydroxyl acid in presence of concentrated sulfuric acid, it will give us the primary amide. So this reaction having advantage over the Lawson and Curtius rearrangement, because in Lawson and Curtius rearrangement we make carboxylic acid into its derivative, and then this derivative will be converted into the primary amide. So in this reaction directly we can use the carboxylic acid to convert into the primary amide. So let us write here the conversion. Conversion is the carboxylic acid to the primary amide. So see, this is the conversion. Carboxylic acid to primary amide. Carboxylic acid to primary amide. So very simple way, we can write here the structure of carboxylic acid. This is the carboxylic acid. When this carboxylic acid react with hydroxylic acid, so this is hydroxylic acid HN3. HN3 is the hydroxylic acid in a presence of concentrated sulfuric acid. Then it gives the primary. Discuss here the mechanism. See, mechanism of this reaction. This is the carboxylic acid RCOH. When react with firstly concentrated sulfuric acid, generates the H plus ion, and this lone pair of oxygen will take this H plus ion, and there will be formation of good living group, that is the H2O plus. This good living group will be eliminated as a water by the dehydration reaction, and see, this is R C double bond O, and this carbon of having positive charge, and by the resonance effect we know that this lone pair will make CL double bond and got the R C triple bond O, and now this oxygen having positive charge. See here the hydroxylic acid, that is HN3. This H having positive charge here and this N3 having negative charge here. This N3 will be attached to this carbon and this bond will be open here and positive charge on the nitrogen will be neutralized here. So this is R, this is carbon, this is double bond O, and this is the N3 is attached here. Now this N3 can be write in this way. This is nitrogen, this is another nitrogen, second nitrogen, and this is the last nitrogen. The middle nitrogen having positive charge and this nitrogen having no negative charge. Now this negative charge makes here double bond, carbon nitrogen double bond. This carbon oxygen double bond will get open here. There will be formation of negative charge on oxygen. Again this negative charge makes here double bond, that is the reformation of double bond, and at that time this alkyl group will migrate from carbon to nitrogen, and this nitrogen gas will be evolved, and after nitrogen gas will be evolved, we got here the intermediate isocyanate. See, this is the R, this is R attached to the nitrogen, this nitrogen having double bond with this carbon, and this carbon having double bond with this oxygen, and we know that when this isocyanate react with the water, it will be giving us primary amide. primary amine. So this is very simple mechanism. Firstly, carboxylic acid react with the mineral acid, that is concentrated sulfuric acid. At that time, by the dehydration of water, got there this intermediate species, and this intermediate species by resonance with this species, so then after hydroxylic acid, the azide group will attach to this carbonyl carbon, and it will be get open here, and it give us the acyl azide. This acyl azide is isocyanic, and isocyanic when it react with water, it will convert into the primary amine. So friend, as we react carboxylic acid with the hydroxylic acid, then it will be given as the primary amine. By the same way, we can react ketone and aldehyde with the hydroxylic acid. Let us see here the mechanism for ketone.
Amine type of compound, or this carbon having here positive charge, and this amine type of compound reacts with then it give us the substituted amides. It will be give us the substituted amides. So we can use the Smith reaction to the ketone also. Let us discuss now when Smith reaction will attach to the when Smith reaction will apply to the aldehyde. So for aldehyde, we can write here, this is the aldehyde here. When aldehyde will takes proton from concentrated sulfuric acid, then there will be formation of this compound. So again, when this compound react with this hydrogen, hydrogenic acid, then hydrogenic acid attach to the carbonyl carbon, and it will be get open here, and after it will be get open here, we got this type of compound. Now this R will be shifted here. When this R will be shifted here, here will be the hydrogen. It will be get removed. So instead of this R dash, here is the hydrogen, and after giving the after reacting the water, it will be give us the substituted formamide. Here are the two possibilities. In one possibility, this alkyl group will migrate on nitrogen, and in second possibility, this hydrogen will be migrate on nitrogen. So in second possibility, we can show here the migration of hydrogen. When hydrogen will be migrate here, what will be remain here? You can see here. So see, this is the R. So we can write here from hydrogen. This hydrogen is attached to this hydrogen. R. See, this is R. This is carbon here. This is double bond here. And nitrogen. And this nitrogen attached to the this hydrogen. This group will be removed here. So this carbon now having positive charge. This carbon now having positive charge here. As we use here the concentrated sulfuric acid, this concentrated sulfuric acid after giving the H plus, there will be remaining the conjugate base HSO4 minus, which will take this hydrogen and this bond division here, and you got here RC triple bond nitrogen. That is the nitrogen. So this is very simple mechanism. So by which we can convert here the aldehyde, by which we can convert it in here aldehyde to the substituted formamides or nitrates. Friend, you have to remember one thing. This Smith reaction can be used for the acid, can be used for the ketone, can be used for the aldehyde. So very simple way, we can say that when acid is react with hydroxyl acid, then at that time there will be formation of primary amine. Ketone react with the hydroxyl acid, then ketone will be converted into the substituted amide. Aldehyde when react with hydroxyl acid, then aldehyde will be converted into the substituted formamide and nitrates. Let us see one example here. This is the example of Smith reaction. Here we have to taken the cyclohexanol, and this cyclohexanol react with the hydroxyl acid in presence of concentrated sulfuric acid. So cyclohexanol is the ketone here, and as we discuss, when ketone react with the hydroxyl acid, it will be give us the substituted substituted amides. Let us see here how it gives the substituted amides. See, this is the cyclohexanol. When react with H2SO4, H2SO4 gives us the H plus ion here. The lone pair of oxygen takes this H plus ion, and we got here, the this is the carbon double bond oxygen. This is carbon double bond oxygen.
it open here and got here the new structure, new intermediate like this. This is oxygen, this is hydrogen, and here is the nitrogen, which having one hydrogen, and this is the another nitrogen, triple bond nitrogen. Now this nitrogen having one. Then see here in this case, this double or this hydrogen will be shifted here, and this OH will be removed. So by this way, after the dehydration reaction, you got here the structure like this. This is the double bond nitrogen. This is double bond nitrogen here, and this is N plus here, and this is the triple bond nitrogen. This is N plus, and this is the triple bond nitrogen here. Now you can see here.
So this is example of Smith rearrangement.